It's time now for a Sunday morning Q&A, and joining us this morning is Curtis Valentine. He's the executive director of MarylandCAN. Good morning.
Good morning. How are you?
I'm doing pretty good. So first of all, what is MarylandCAN? This is a new organization.
Yes, we are. We're the Maryland Campaign for Achievement Now. So we're a statewide education advocacy organization that we believe puts the public back into public education.
Okay, so how do you seek to do that?
Well, we seek to put parents, teachers, but also Marylanders in general, direct contact with those who make the laws, the state legislatures, school board members, and saying collectively, bringing our voices together, that we'd have much more impact on changing education here in Maryland.
And this is something that you work on all throughout the year, not just during the legislative session.
Yes, we are a small but savvy team of folks here in Maryland, of parents and advocates who say, at least in the short term, our audience are those legislators in Annapolis. But throughout the year, it's important to us that we bring together parents and firefighters and small business owners together, because we believe that great schools change everything. They change health care. They change the housing price of your house. They change the crime rate in your community, but also jobs. And how we do that throughout the year is something that we believe we need to do, because it's that important.
You have a few issues that you're specifically focusing on this year, and one of them is charter schools. You want to work on different legislation for charter schools. Why is that?
Well, we're working very closely with charter school operators here in Baltimore and throughout the state, but also hearing from parents who are asking for greater choices in where they send their schools. So we're looking to work with everyone who's at the table and say, how can we create a better environment for operators, for current operators, future operators, but more importantly for parents who are saying that we deserve greater choices. The school that I've been sending my child to has not prepared my child for the future. And as a parent, and I'm a parent, I totally understand, they are saying, I want an opportunity to see if there's another opportunity with a charter school or any other school that's out there.
Also advocating for fully funded all-day pre-K for students in the state of Maryland.
Yes, I mean, we believe Maryland has one of the largest achievement gaps in the country, and the idea that early childhood development has one of the most direct impacts of really reducing these achievement gaps even before they start. We also understand that in a time of austerity, you know, in our state, we're looking at budget cuts. We also know that early child development is the best return on investment for education. For every $1 you spend on early child education, you get $7 in savings over the lifetime of a student who's more likely to go to college, more likely to graduate from high school, more likely to be reading at grade three. And we think that it's important that we come up with solutions that are both impactful but also very practical.
And you don't want only the state to get involved and schools to get involved. You're asking more parents to get involved, but you also want it to make it easier for parents to be involved in their children's educational lives.
Absolutely. I come from a campaign background, working with President Obama on his 2008 campaign. And I think when you're working on campaigns, political campaigns, it's important that you break down sort of tasks in the simplest of forms, because people you're asking to work on your campaigns, or they're very busy, they're parents, they're working full time. So how can we take the 1 hour you have a day, the 2 hours you have a week, and say, I want to add that with the 2 hours that your neighbor has, and collectively say, you have an impact on what I believe is the most important issue of my generation.
So how can parents get involved?
Great.
Or people in general?
I think, you know, go to our website, www.marylandcan.org, register with us. We'll be engaging and mobilizing parents, but again, I said Marylanders in general, to say, how can we collectively advocate and push for legislation in the short term that affects our education, but also come to the table, come out to our forums, sit down with us and say, for the first time, this is your opportunity to speak directly to those who have power. Collectively, we are much more powerful than we are individually.
All right, Curtis Valentine, MarylandCAN, thank you so much for
joining
us.
Thanks so much for having me.
Very nice to meet you. Good information.
Yes.
And next week, our guest will be Congressman Dutch Ruppersberger. If you have a question for him, please send them in, or you can email your questions to SundayQuestions@WBALTV.com. And please don't go